Hello, we're the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. Today we have a few SpaceX updates including the still delayed Starlink 9 and the upcoming ANASIS-II launch. However, most of the video will be spent over in Boca Chica where a whole load of activity has been taking place. Lots of stuff to cover today, so let's head straight in and get up to date. To start off the SpaceX updates today, we have a tweet from reporter Michael Sheets. With Crew Dragon Endeavour attached to the ISS, there is a lot of testing going on with the vehicle. One of the tests is how comfortable the vehicle will be with four astronauts inside. Apparently, they have performed a one-hour demonstration of the spacecraft's habitability. Next, we have Starlink 9, which as per last episode was supposed to launch on Wednesday. However, SpaceX tweeted last minute that they were standing down. They then announced that they would be targeting Saturday, July 11th for the launch of the 10th batch of Starlink satellites. However, yesterday they once again posted a tweet bearing bad news. They said, "Standing down from today's launch of the 10th Starlink mission to allow more time for checkouts. Team is working to identify the next launch opportunity. We'll announce a new target date once confirmed with the range." With this news, we can now look to the next launch, which as I mentioned last video is ANASIS-II. SpaceX have tweeted, "Static fire test complete targeting July 14th for Falcon 9 launch of ANASIS-II from Slick 40 in Florida." That was then followed by another tweet which says, "The booster supporting this mission previously launched NASA astronauts Bob Behnken and Doug Hurley to the International Space Station." As I said, most of the video will be taking a look at Boca Chica and Starship, so let's head there. First up is the Starship Superheavy launch pad construction, and here is the latest view of what's been happening. We've recently seen a whole load of progress on the new walls by the launch mount. They've progressed even further and you can see they are looking almost complete. Over by the landing pad, further groundwork has been happening. Not sure what exactly it is they are preparing for here, but they are clearing up the dirt at the moment. Some new arrivals for the testing area have been spotted on some trailers. You can see here, SpaceX have taken delivery of three brand new tanks for the fuel farm. We recently saw a whole bunch of new equipment attached to the top of a tank at the fuel farm. Some of the equipment we saw were some inactive cameras. However, as you can see here, they've recently configured and set up the new cameras. I think when Starship hops, we might get some amazing angles. Also, recently we've not only seen a new doghouse for Zeus, but we've also seen Zeus himself. Not a typical dog, Zeus is a spot robot manufactured by Boston Dynamics. He's previously been seen inspecting the SN7 test tank, but for now Zeus is not needed and so has been hanging out in front of his kennel. However, a SpaceXer was spotted controlling Zeus in order to place him back inside the kennel. Elsewhere around the Boca Chica facility, some new rolls of stainless steel have been seen arriving. This roll was spotted being added to a large stack of rolls that is sitting by the side of the road. Just look at how much stainless steel they have. Also, for a while, over by these many rolls of steel, the old Mark 1 fins was sitting outside by the road. SpaceX have now lifted and started moving these fins. What for is anybody's guess, but I would say the intention might be to reuse them. Here you can see one of the fins was chucked on the back of a trailer attached to a pickup truck. They then transported the component over to the construction area. Over by the construction area, workers were spotted digging and moving dirt. So it looks like the company is set to expand the facility even more with some more production infrastructure planned. Remember though, the company is not only building a rocket, they are also designing the production line alongside it. I can't wait to see how this place looks in 1 year, let alone 5 or 10 years down the line. For the final bits of Boca Chica activity, we have an insane amount of progress on the high bay. Last episode we saw one corner had already been constructed. You can see here that they were working to construct yet another corner. As you can see, it wasn't very long at all before they lifted yet another section for this new corner. Next, they moved on to some beams to connect these two parts of the structure. So as I said previously, this building is and probably will continue to grow at an incredible pace. Also, take a look at the scale of the structure compared with people, just goes to show what sort of size this building will be. Since then, they have continued even further with more corners being constructed. On top of this, they've also already connected the new corner to the original. It's already beginning to look like a high bay and I'm super excited to start seeing it put to use. With all the standard Boca Chica and infrastructure activity covered, let's look at Starships. Starting with the SN5 vehicle, which you can see being worked on here. Workers were spotted working atop the vehicle in preparation for a new addition. That new addition is something we've briefly seen before, so now SN5 also has a hat. This is a mass simulator, and as you can see from Jack Bayer's editing, it's an estimated 22 tons in weight. It will be used to simulate the weight of the upper rings and nose cone. As you all know, SN5 is currently in the process of preparing for a static fire. I had shared the expected dates last episode, but as often happens, these dates have changed, but more on that in a minute. For now, you can see here, engineers were spotted working underneath the vehicle some more. They've recently been working on the piping to help feed fuel into the prototype. Before we have a look at some other Starship pieces, I'll show you the latest in road and beach closures. You can see on the Cameron County website there are currently a few dates remaining. Last episode we were expecting Friday 10th, Saturday and Sunday. However, as of right now, we currently only have Monday, Tuesday and Wednesday. As always though, depending on various factors, these dates could change again. For now though, let's see some activity with another piece of SN5 that we've not talked about for a while. Remember the nose cone ring stack that was chilling outside the mid bay for ages? Well now, they have hooked it up to a crane, lifted it and placed it onto a construction mount. This section was then spotted being moved over by one of the onion tents, and at first I thought it was moved inside. However, it appears that it has actually been moved over to the windbreaker. In addition to this section being moved, another section, which is the actual nose cone itself, has also been moved. You can see here the ring stack has been put inside the windbreaker whilst the nose cone is currently still waiting outside. Looks like we could see a new full-size fairing stacked soon. Just before we take a look at some pieces spotted for a new Starship, just want to show you an existing vehicle. Under construction for a while and most recently just hanging out in the mid bay, we have SN6. With SN5 getting prepared for testing, I'm guessing SN6 is now just waiting its turn to be a part of history. Finally, I would usually name the next full Starship, but with the SN7 tank, it's hard to say what the next serial number will be. So this is now where we will look at the next Starship tank which is going to be constructed. Recently, there has been an interesting collection of thrust sections that were spotted, starting with this section that was recently spotted inside a tent. Then, a thrust section was seen being moved outside, but I'm not sure if it's the same section. After being moved outside, this segment was moved over to the mid bay. However, I believe it was then moved back inside for further work. Interestingly, a different part of a thrust section was moved into the mid bay, something I don't think we've seen before at this stage. I'm pretty sure what I've just explained is how it happened, but with the way the clips are put together, it's hard to say. However, it looks like SpaceX are on their way to having SN8 or SN9 potentially start stacking soon. Longer video than usual today, but lots of stuff has been happening over at the Texas facility. The person to thank the most for this is Mary, otherwise known as Boca Chica Girl, who spends hours every day capturing this awesome footage. Also, more recently, Jack Bayer has been adding some great editing to the videos and highlighting certain things in clips. However, the whole NSF team deserves our gratitude because they all work very hard to bring us amazing space coverage. That's it for this episode of The SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.